the echidna, and the shade tree. Away out in the middle of the desert, there once grew a huge tree. It was so big that it shaded the whole land from the scorching sun. All the animals lived in the shade of this tree. Each day they would hunt for food, while old echidna stayed behind. He looked after the children. Each time when the animals returned with the food, they would give the children the tastiest bits. But poor old echidna only got the scraps. I bet there would barely be any scraps. This made echidna very angry. He grabbed hold of that giant shade tree and shook it. He pulled it, and with a mighty tug, tore it right out of the ground, roots and all. He put the tree on his back and stomped off. Soon the animals realized that the shade was moving, and that they would die first in the hot sun. They chased after echidna and begged him to stop. They begged him to put the tree back. But he just marched on in anger. The animals threw a boomerang. Surely that would stop him. No, it won't. But it didn't. It hit him on the feet and broke his toes. But he still shuffled on, apparently. At last the animals hurled their spears. I like the black and white one. The echidna howled in pain. Soon he was completely covered with spears, apparently. The giant tree crashed to the ground, and it rolled over and over across the plain, and its huge branches took off and stuck into the ground. How lucky. Poor echidna lay dying. Soon the animals began to feel sorry for him. Cockatoo flew up and asked, "Where would you like to be buried?" In an ant bed? Nah. In a clump of Spinifex grass? Nah. In between some rocks? Yes. Echidna chose the rocks. When he died, the animals buried him there and covered him up. Only the spears were sticking out. To this day, echidnas have spears on their backs. They still shuffle about on little bent and broken feet as they hunt the ants amongst the rocks. The animals, too, still live in the desert. They hunt in the shade of the small trees that grew from the branches of that one giant tree. And they will never die first because water filled up the hole left by the shade tree and made a huge lake